Pamphylia to Amphilanthus by Lady Mary Roth. Part 1. Sonnets 1 to 24 and Songs 1 through 4. Sonnet 1. When night's black mantle could most darkness prove, and sleep, death's image, did my senses hire from knowledge of myself, then thoughts did move swifter than those most swiftness need require. In sleep, a chariot drawn by winged desire I saw, where sat bright Venus, queen of love, and at her feet her son, still adding fire to burning hearts which she did hold above. But one heart flaming more than all the rest, the goddess held, and put it to my breast. "Dear son, now shoot," said she, "thus must we win." He her obeyed, and martyred my poor heart. I waking hoped as dreams it would depart, yet since, oh me, a lover I have been. 2. Dear eyes, how well indeed you do adorn that blessed sphere which gazing souls hold dear, the loved place of sought-for triumphs, near the court of glory, where love's force was born. How may they term you April's sweetest morn, when pleasing looks from those bright lights appear a sunshine day, from clouds and mist still clear, kind nursing fires for wishes yet unborn. Two stars of heaven sent down to grace the earth, placed in that throne which gives all joys their birth, shining and burning, pleasing yet their charms, which wounding even in hurts are deemed delights. So pleasant is their force, so great their mights, as happy they can triumph in their harms. 3. Yet is there hope. Then, love, but play thy part. Remember well thyself, and think on me. Shine in those eyes which conquered have my heart, and see if mine be slack to answer thee. Lodge in that breast, and pity moving see, for flames which in mine burn in truest smart, exiling thoughts that touch inconstancy, or those which waste not in the constant art. Watch but my sleep, if I take any rest, for thought of you my spirit so distressed, as, pale and famished, I for mercy cry. Will you your servant leave? Think but on this, who wears love's crown, must not do so amiss, but seek their good, who on thy force do lie. 4. Forbear, dark night, my joys now bud again, lately grown dead while cold aspects did chill the root at heart, and my chief hope quite kill, and thunders strook me in my pleasure's wane. Then I, alas, with bitter sobs and pain, privately groaned my fortune's present ill. All light of comfort dimmed, woes and prides fill, with strange increase of grief I grieved in vain. And most, when as a memory to good molested me, which still as witness stood of those best days in former time I knew, late gone as wonders past, like the great snow, melted and wasted, with what change must know. Now back the life comes, whereas once it grew. 5. Can pleasing sight misfortune ever bring? Can firm desire a painful torment try? Can winning eyes prove to the heart a sting? Or can sweet lips in treason hidden lie? The sun most pleasing blinds the strongest eye, if too much looked on, breaking the sight's string. Desires still crossed must unto mischief hie, and as despair a luckless chance may fling. Eyes having won, rejecting proves a sting, killing the bud before the tree doth spring. Sweet lips, not loving, do as poison prove. Desire, sight, eyes, lips, seek, see, prove, and find. You love may win, but curses if unkind. then show you harm's dislike and joy in love. 6. O strive not still to heap disdain on me, nor pleasure take your cruelty to show on hapless me, on whom all sorrows flow, and biding make, has given and lost by thee. Alas, even grief is grown to pity me. Scorn cries out gainst itself such ill to show, and would give place for joy's delights to flow. Yet wretched I, all tortures bear from thee. Long have I suffered, and esteemed it dear, since such thy will yet grew my pain more near. Wish you my end, say so, you shall it have, for all the depth of my heart-held despair is that for you I feel not death for care, but now I'll seek it, since you will not save. Song 1. The spring now come at last to trees, fields, to flowers, and meadows makes to taste his pride, while sad showers which from mine eyes do flow makes known with cruel pains. Cold winter yet remains, no sign of spring we know. The sun which to the earth gives heat, light, and pleasure, joys in spring, hateth dearth, plenty makes his treasure. His heat to me is cold, his light all darkness is, since I am barred of bliss, I heat nor light behold. A shepherdess thus said, who was with grief oppressed, for truest love betrayed, barred her from quiet rest, and weeping thus said she, my end approacheth near, now willow must I wear, my fortune so will be. With branches of this tree I'll dress my hapless head, which shall my witness be. My hopes in love are dead, my clothes embroidered all shall be with garlands round, some scattered, others bound, some tied, some like to fall. The bark my book shall be, where daily I will write this tale of hapless me, true slave to fortune's spite. The root shall be my bed, where nightly I will lie wailing in constancy, since all true love is dead. And these lines I will leave, if some such lover come, who may them right conceive and place them on my tomb. She who still constant loved, now dead with cruel care, killed with unkind despair, and change her end here proved. Sonnet 7. Love, leave to urge. Thou knowest thou hast the hand. 'Tis cowardice to strive where none resist. Pray, leave thee off. I yield unto thy band. Do not thus still in thine own power persist. Behold, I yield. Let forces be dismissed. I am thy subject conquered, bound to stand, never thy foe, but did thy claim assist, seeking thy due of those who did withstand. But now it seems thou wouldst I should thee love. I do confess, 'twas thy will made me choose, and thy fair shows made me a lover prove, when I my freedom did for pain refuse. Yet this, Sir God, your boyship I despise, your charms I obey, but love not want of eyes. 8. Led by the power of grief to wailings brought, by false conceit of change fallen on my part, I seek for some small ease by lines which bought increase the pain. Grief is not cured by art. Ah, how unkindness moves within the heart, which still is true and free from changing thought! What unknown woe it breeds, what endless smart, with ceaseless tears which causelessly are wrought! It makes me now to shun all shining light, and seek for blackest clouds me light to give, which to all others only darkness drive. They on me shine, for sun disdains my sight. Yet though I dark do live, I triumph may. Unkindness, nor this wrong, shall love allay. 9. Be you all pleased, your pleasures grieve not me. Do you delight? I envy not your joy. Have you content? Contentment with you be. Hope you for bliss. Hope still, and still enjoy. Let sad misfortune hapless me destroy. Leave crosses to rule me, and still rule free, while all delights their contraries employ, to keep good back, and I but torments see. Joys are bereaved me, harms to only tarry, despair takes place, disdain hath got the hand. Yet firm love holds my senses in such band, as, since despised, I with sorrow marry. Then if with grief I now must coupled be, sorrow I'll wed, despair thus governs me. 10. The weary traveller, who tired, sought in places distant far, yet found no end of pain or labour, nor his state to mend, at last with joy is to his home back brought, finds not more ease though he with joy be fraught, when past is fear content like souls ascend. Then I, on whom new pleasures do descend, which now as high as first-born bliss is wrought, he tired with his pains, I with my mind. He all content receives by ease of limbs. I, greatest happiness that I do find, belief for faith, while hope in pleasure swims. Truth saith 'twas wrong conceit bred my despite, which once acknowledged brings my heart's delight. 11. You endless torments that my rest oppress, how long will you delight in my sad pain? Will never love your favour more express? Shall I still live, and ever feel disdain? Alas, now stay, and let my grief obtain some end. Feed not my heart with sharp distress. Let me once see my cruel fortune's gain, at least release, and long-felt woes redress. Let not the blame of cruelty disgrace the honoured title of your godhead love. Give not just cause for me to say, a place is found for rage alone on me to move. Oh, quickly end, and do not long debate my needful aid, lest help do come too late. 12. Cloyed with the torments of a tedious night, I wish for day, which come, I hope for joy. When cross I find new tortures to destroy, my woe-killed heart, first hurt by mischief's might, then cry for night, and once more day takes flight, and brightness gone. What rest should here enjoy usurped is? Hate will her force employ. Night cannot grief entomb, though black as spite. My thoughts are sad, her face as sad doth seem. My pains are long, her hours tedious are. My grief is great, and endless is my care. Her face, her force, and all of woe's esteem. Then welcome night, and farewell flattering day, which all hopes breed, and yet our joys delay. Song 2. All night I weep, all day I cry, ay me. I still do wish, though yet deny, ay me. I sigh, I mourn, I say that still I only am the store for ill, ay me. In coldest hopes I freeze, yet burn, ay me. From flames I strive to fly, yet turn, ay me. From grief I haste, but sorrows high, and on my heart all woes do lie, ay me. From contraries I seek to run, ay me, but contraries I cannot shun, ay me. For they delight their force to try, and to despair my thoughts do tie, ay me. Whither, alas, then shall I go, ay me, when as despair all hopes outgo, ay me? If to the forest Cupid hies, and my poor soul to his law ties, ay me. To the court, oh no, He cries, fie, ay me, there no true love you shall espy, ay me. Leave that place to falsest lovers, your true love all truth discovers, ay me. Then quiet rest, and no more prove, ay me. All places are alike to love, ay me. And constant be in this begun, yet say, till life with love be done, ay me. Sonnet 13. Dear, famish not what you yourself gave food. Destroy not what your glory is to save. Kill not that soul to which you spirit gave. In pity, not disdain, your triumph stood. An easy thing it is to shed the blood of one who at your will yields to the grave. But more you may true worth by mercy crave, when you preserve, not spoil, but nourish good. Your sight is all the food I do desire. Then sacrifice me not in hidden fire, or stop the breath which did your praises move. Think but how easy 'tis a sight to give, nay, even desert, since by it I do live. I but chameleon-like would live and love. 14. Am I thus conquered? Have I lost the powers, that to withstand, which joys to ruin me? Must I be still, while it my strength devours, and captive leads me, prisoner, bound, unfree? Love first shall leave men's fantasies to them free. Desire shall quench love's flames, spring, hate sweet showers. Love shall loose all his darts, have sight, and see his shame and wishings hinder happy hours. Why should we not love's purblind charms resist? Must we be servile, doing what he list? No, seek some host to harbour thee. I fly thy babish tricks, and freedom do profess. But oh, my hurt makes my lost heart confess. I love, and must. So farewell, liberty. 15. Truly, poor knight, thou welcome art to me. I love thee better in this sad attire than that which raiseth some men's fancies higher, like painted outsides which foul inward be. I love thy grave and saddest looks to see, which seems my soul and dying heart entire, like to the ashes of some happy fire that flamed in joy but quenched in misery. I love thy countenance, and thy sober pace, which evenly goes, and as of loving grace to us, and me among the rest oppressed, gives quiet peace to my poor self alone, and freely grants day leave, when thou art gone, to give clear light, to see all ill redressed. 16. Sleep, fie, possess me not, nor do not fright me with thy heavy and thy death-like might, for counterfeiting's vilder than death's sight, and such deluding more my thoughts do spite. Thou sufferest falsest shapes my soul to fright, sometimes in likeness of a hopeful sprite, and oft times like my love, as in despite, joying thou canst with malice kill delight. When I, a poor fool made by thee, think joy doth flow, when thy fond shadows do destroy my that while senseless self left free to thee. But now do well, let me for ever sleep, and so for ever that dear image keep, or still wake that my senses may be free. 17. Sweet shades, why do you seek to give delight to me, who deem delight in this vile place, but torment sorrow in mine own disgrace, to taste of joy or your vain-pleasing sight? Show them your pleasures who saw never night of grief, where joying's fawning smiling face appears as day, where grief found never space, yet for a sigh, a groan, or envy's spite. But oh, on me a world of woes do lie, or else on me all harms strive to rely, and to attend like servants bound to me. Heat in desire, while frosts of care I prove, wanting my love, yet surfeit do with love, burn, and yet freeze, better in hell to be. 18. Which should I better like of, day or night? Since all the day I live in bitter woe, enjoying light more clear my wrongs to know, and yet most sad, feeling in it all spite. In night, when darkness doth forbid all light, yet see I grief apparent to the show, followed by jealousy whose fond tricks flow, and on unconstant waves of doubt alight. I can behold rage cowardly to feed upon foul error which these humours breed, shame, doubt, and fear, yet boldly will think ill. All those in both I feel, then which is best, dark to joy by day, light in night oppressed? Leave both and end, these but each other spill. Song 3. Stay, my thoughts, do not aspire to vain hopes of high desire. See you not all means bereft, to enjoy no joy is left. Yet still methinks my thoughts do say, some hopes do live amid dismay. Hope then once more, hope for joy, bury fear which joys destroy. Thought hath yet some comfort given, which despair hath from us driven. Therefore dearly my thoughts cherish, never let such thinking perish. 'Tis an idle thing to plain, odder far to die for pain. Think and see how thoughts do rise, winning where there no hope lies, which alone is lover's treasure, for by thoughts we love do measure. Then kind thought my fancy guide, let me never hapless slide. Still maintain thy force in me, let me thinking still be free, nor leave thy might until my death, but let me thinking yield up breath. Sonnet 19. Come, darkest night, becoming sorrow best, light, leave thy light, fit for a lightsome soul. Darkness doth truly suit with me oppressed, whom absence power doth from mirth control. The very trees with hanging heads condole sweet summer's parting, and of leaves distressed, in dying colours make a grief full roll. So much, alas, to sorrow are they pressed. Thus of dead leaves her farewell carpets made, their fall, their branches, all their mournings prove, with leafless, naked bodies, whose hues fade from hopeful green to wither in their love. If trees and leaves for absence mourners be, no marvel that I grieve, who like want see. 20. The sun which glads the earth at his bright sight, when in the morn he shows his golden face, and takes the place from tedious, drowsy night, making the world still happy in his grace, shows happiness remains not in one place, nor may the heavens alone to us give light, but hide that cheerful face, though no long space, yet long enough for trial of their might. But never sunset could be so obscure, no desert ever had a shade so sad, nor could black darkness ever prove so bad as pains which absence makes me now endure. The missing of the sun awhile makes night, but absence of my joy sees never light. 21. When last I saw thee, I did not see thee. It was thine image which in my thoughts lay so lively figured, as no time's delay could suffer me in heart to parted be. And sleep so favourable is to me, as not to let thy loved remembrance stray, lest that I waking might have cause to say, there was 1 minute found to forget thee. Then, since my faith is such, so kind my sleep, that gladly thee presents into my thought, and still true lover-like thy face doth keep, so as some pleasure shadow-like is wrought. Pity, my loving, nay, of conscience give reward to me in whom thyself doth live. 22. Like to the Indians scorched with the sun which they do as their god adore, so am I used by love, for evermore I worship him, less favours have I won. Better are they who thus to blackness run, and so can only whiteness want deplore, than I who pale and white am with grief's store, nor can have hope but to see hopes undone. Besides their sacrifice received in sight of their chose saint, mine hid as worthless rite, grant me to see where I my offerings give. Then let me wear the mark of Cupid's might, in heart as they in skin of Phoebus light, not ceasing offerings to love while I live. 23. When every one to pleasing pastime hies, some hunt, some hawk, some play, while some delight in sweet discourse and music shows joy's might. Yet I my thoughts do far above these prize. The joy which I take is that free from eyes I sit and wonder at this day-like night, so to dispose themselves as void of right, and leave true pleasure for poor vanities. When others hunt, my thoughts I have in chase. If hawk, my mind at wished end doth fly. Discourse, I with my spirit talk and cry, while others music choose as greatest grace. O God, say I, can these fond pleasures move, or music be but in sweet thoughts of love? 24. Once did I hear an aged father say unto his son, who with attention hears what age and wise experience ever clears from doubts of fear, or reason to betray. My son, said he, behold thy father gray. I once had, as thou hast, fresh, tender years, and like thee sported destitute of fears. But my young faults made me too soon decay. Love once I did, and like thee feared my love, led by the hateful thread of jealousy, striving to keep, I lost my liberty, and gained my grief, which still my sorrows move. In time shun this, to love is no offence, but doubt in youth, in age breeds penitence. Song 4. Sweetest love, return again, make not too long stay, killing mirth and forcing pain, sorrow leading way. Let us not thus parted be, love and absence near agree. But since you must needs depart, and me hapless leave, in your journey take my heart, which will not deceive. Yours it is, to you it flies, joying in those loved eyes. So in part we shall not part, though we absent be. Time nor place nor greatest smart shall my bands make free. Tied I am, yet think it gain, in such knots I feel no pain. But can I live, having lost chiefest part of me? Heart is fled, and sight is crossed, these my fortunes be. Yet, dear heart, go, soon return, as good there as here to burn. End of Part 1.